Hi, my name is Chris Nelson and welcome to our online class. In this section, I'm going to work on how to do the double block and the outside block. So double block, imagine someone is coming up and grabbing you and you're going to use two hands to defend yourself. So again, we always want to think about maximizing our power, and if you're in a self-defense situation, usually it's someone who's bigger than you, stronger than you, so we want to kind of use all those karate secrets to maximize the extra strength that we can get, especially for kids. They're probably going to be attacked either by a bully or by some type of child predator, so we want to be able to get as much oomph into it as we can. And one of the ways we do that is by getting the wrist to snap. It gets more power and snap at the end. So we're going to have everyone make an X with their hands. And then as someone grabs you, you're gonna bring both hands out and snap it out. So you're hitting with that hard bone. Hitting with that hard bone. So it's snap, snap, snap. All right, and a way to practice this, I'm gonna have Mr. Drescher come up. He's gonna be our attacker. By the way, one of the things, let's do it slow motion. As he grabs me, I'm hitting, and notice what I'm hitting. Again, I'm hitting with the blade of that arm, which there's really not any sensitivity in there, it's pretty strong, but I'm hitting the inside of his, and you got a medial nerve that runs down the belly of that muscle, and so when I'm hitting that real hard, it hurts a lot, and it tends to start making the arms numb, so be careful. If you're doing this without pads, we're not going to probably hit full speed, but we're going to get that snap going. So he grabbed me, and I, bam, double block, hit, hit, hit. All right, and this would be a good drill for you to practice at home. If you got somebody that just keep grabbing, if you don't, just stand in front of the mirror. Just practice those snaps. I used to sit in front of the mirror at the karate school and just practice all my blocks, getting snaps. All right, the next technique that I'm gonna do, so that was the double block. The outside form block, again, it's the same thing. And we do this with adults and 4 to 7 year olds and 8 to 12 year olds. A lot of times we're in a fighting stance. For now, I'm just gonna keep it straight ahead so we can practice this. So it's a double block. So if I did one hand instead of doing both, if I do one hand, I'm snapping it out. So if a punch was coming this way, I'd block it out that way. If I had a punch coming from this side, I'd block it out that way. It's the exact same thing as we did with that, but it's just gonna be one hand or the other. Now, a good drill for this would be, I'm gonna have Mr. Drescher start off first alternating, so it gives my brain and my body a chance to work together. So he's gonna throw one hand and I block, and I come back to the X and block, and he's just gonna keep alternating, 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 alternating. And I just get to practice this, and what I'm doing is I build muscle memory. So we never wanna get to the point where we just do a few and say, ah, I got it, because in stress, what happens is the brain kind of shuts down, and then people are left just kind of blank. So the key to that is to be able to do lots and lots of it. So the body, the muscle memory has it without using the brain at all. All right, the next thing is I'm gonna have him just test me a little bit. So I'm gonna stand here, my hands X, and this would be a really good drill that we could do at home. And he is gonna mix it up randomly. Sometimes he'll throw that hand, and I'm gonna block it. Oh, he threw the same one. I just have to react to it. Oh, he got two on me. All right, stop. So see how that works? There would be another drill. You could spend 2 or 3 minutes doing that. Have some fun with it. But that's, again, a great way to build that muscle memory. So go practice that for a little bit and then do the next section.